Hello students of class 6, today I am going to discuss some of the questions of chapter 2. So come to the first question, you have to fill in the blank. So number A is 89 plus 87 is equal to dash plus 89. So see here, in left hand side part we have 89 plus 87 and in right hand side we have 89. So in blank space, the value will be what? 87. Because left hand side should be equal to right hand side. As equal to sign is present, that means we have to balance both the sides. So left hand side, when left hand side is equal to right hand side, when in blank space we will put the value 87. So here we are using the commutative property for addition in whole numbers. So according to commutative property, we have a plus b is equal to b plus a. Similarly, come to question number b. In question number b, see 863 plus 0 is equal to dash plus 863. So in dash, we have to put 0. See here, we can say that we are using two properties. First is commutative property of addition, because whenever we change the order, the answer will remain same. So in left hand side part we have 863 plus 0, therefore in right hand side part also already 863 is present, that means in blank space there should be what? 0. So here we can say we are using commutative property for addition in whole numbers, or we can say the additive identity in whole numbers. So what is the additive identity in whole numbers? 0 is the additive identity in whole numbers, because whenever we add 0 to any whole number, we will get the same whole number again. Come to the second question. You have to mark true or false in this case. See the question number A. 18 minus 3 in bracket, after that minus 1 is equal to 18 minus, again in bracket it is 3 minus 1. As you can see, we are using here associative property, because in associative property you have to take 3 whole numbers and the 2 whole numbers will be in bracket. Okay, so and you have to change the order. So here we are changing the order, means the order is changed. So 3 minus 1 is in bracket in right hand side, but in left hand side we have 18 minus 3 in bracket. So when we solve left hand side and right hand side separately, we will get both the answer different. So already we know that associative property in subtraction does not holds true. So this property will be what? This property is false in case of subtraction. That means it is not satisfied in case of subtraction. That means this statement is also what? Is also false. So this statement you have to, this statement will be what? False. Next is come to number B. See, in number B, B and A both are same. Only there is a difference of symbol. So in A we have subtraction symbol, but in B we have plus symbol. That means here addition is taken place. So in case of addition, we already know that associative property in case of addition of whole number is satisfied. That means it holds true in case of addition. So if you solve left hand side and right hand side proper separately, for example, if I solve here in left hand side part, see in bracket we have 46 plus 4, so 46 plus 4 will be 50, and 50 plus 8 will be what? 58. And in right hand side part again, 8 plus 4, as this is in bracket, you have to solve the bracket first. 4 plus 8 will be 12, and 12 plus 46 will be what? 58. So the left hand side answer and right hand side answer both are same. Also, we know the property that associative property in case of addition in whole number holds true. And this is what? This is the associative property. So this holds true. That means the statement is what? The statement is correct. So come to question number 3. In question number 3, you have to solve the following using associative property. So in associative property, already you know you have to solve this. You have to solve this expression. So see, in left hand side part, or you can say in right hand side part, you have to add the two terms first. So the two numbers means, suppose in left hand side we have to add B and C, but in right hand side you have to add A plus B, means A and B. That means you have to first take two numbers, any two numbers you can take. First of all you have to add that two number, then after adding the answer, that answer you have to add with the third number. So that is the process in associative property. So here we have to see in question number A, which two numbers you have to take first. So see here, this is 64 and this is 36. So you can easily see the ones place. In the ones place you have 4 and 6. When you add 6 and 4, you will get 10. And in 10, in ones place we have what? 0. So you have to see which number we can add so that the ones place will be equal to 0. That means you have to add two numbers. By adding the two numbers, you will get the answer. And that answer, in that answer, you have to check the ones place. If ones place is 0, you have to add that two number first. So why I am doing this, I will give you the reason after solving. So but first of all you have to check that which number you will add to get the answer in ones place as 0. So see here, 7, 4 and 6 are present in ones place. So when we add 7 and 4, we will get what? 11. So in 11 we have 1 in ones place. So we will not add 87 and 64. Again check 64 and 36. So here ones place is 4, here ones place is 6. That's why we will add these two terms, because when we add 4 and 6 we will get 10, and in 10 we have 0 in tens place. So this is the process you have to write using the associative property. 87 plus 64 plus 36 is equal to 87 plus, in bracket you have to write 64 plus 36. Because according to associative property, you have to take, you have to add two numbers first. So here we are adding 64 and 36. So the answer we will get is 100, and 100 plus 87 will be 187. So why we are taking 64 and 36 in bracket? Because it will add up to 100, and you know if we add any number to 100, we will directly get the answer. So that's the main reason why I am taking 64 and 36 in bracket. Next question, fill in the blanks. So see, in before equal to, that means this is the left hand side part. In left hand side we have four numbers. In right hand side part we have two numbers. One is given as 100, but second number is not given. You have to write the second number. So what should be the second number? See, 100 is there. That means you have to add any two numbers from these four numbers to get 100 first. So which number we have to add? See, 90 and 10. If we add 90 and 10, we will get 100. That means this term you need not to add again, because this already added. This is already added to get what? 100. So next, what term is remaining here? Here only 73 and 7, the two numbers are remaining. So 73 and 7, when we add, we will get the answer 80. So in blank, it will be what? 80. Next, come to question number 5. You have to name the property. Here you have to only name the property. No need to do any calculation. See, in number A, we have 19 plus 63 equal to 63 plus 19. See, in left hand side and right hand side, they have changed the order. Means in place of 63 it is written 19, in place of 19 it is written 63. And between both the numbers, it is what? Positive symbol is there, means plus symbol is there. So this is the property of what? This is the commutative property of addition in whole number. So you have to write the property that you have to write an answer, and you have to write commutative property of addition in whole numbers. Of addition in whole numbers. Similarly, in question number B, this is written 20 plus 0 is equal to 20. That means whenever we are adding 0 to any whole number, we will get the same whole number again. And this property is called additive identity in whole numbers. So you have to write additive identity. Next, in number C, see here we have 3 whole numbers. And in bracket we have 2 whole numbers. Again, order is changed. That means in bracket the terms have changed in right hand side part. So as you already know, this is the associative property of addition in whole numbers. So in answer you have to write, this is the associative property of addition in whole numbers. Next, I am going to discuss the next exercise, that is exercise 2.2. So question number 1 is, you have to mark true or false. So question number A is 36 plus 64 equal to 64 plus 36. So this is true. As you all know, this is the commutative property for addition in whole numbers. So this property holds true. So you have to mark true for this. Next is number B. 100 divided by 5 equal to 5 divided by 100. So here also the order is changed, but here the symbol is division. So as already you know that commutative property in case of division, it is not satisfied. So this statement is what? Wrong. So next is number C. 683 into 1 is equal to 1 into 683. So here also see, when we multiply two whole numbers, the order does not change the answer. Or the order does not change the solution. So that means this statement is also true. This property is commutative property in multiplication. Next, come to question number 2. You have to fill in the boxes. Number A, 6 into blank is equal to 6. So what will be the number in blank? See, what number you should add to 6? What number you should multiply to 6 to get again 6? Yes. We will multiply what? 1. When we multiply 1 to 6, we will get the same number again, 6. And this is called what? This is the multiplicative identity. Next is number B. 9 into 8 is equal to 8 into, what will be the next number? See, here it will be 9. See here, already in right hand side we are having what? 8. That means next you have to write what? 9. Because 8 is already present, as you know, equal to means what? We have to balance the two sides, that is left hand side part and right hand side part. So which number we will put to right hand side in blank space so that the right hand side part should be equal to left hand side. See here, the answer will be what? 9 into 8 will be what? 72. So which number should be multiplied to 8 to get 72 again? Yes, the answer is 9. So we have to put 9. And this property is commutative property in case of multiplication. Next is number C. In number C, we have 3 numbers, 173, 54 and 46. In right hand side, we have only 100, but we have to write in blank space. See here, which number you are adding to get 100? So 54 and 46. When we add 54 and 46, we will get 100. That means these two numbers are already added. That means what is the next number you have to write? Yes, you have to write 173 because it is remaining. So this will be what? 173. And you can see, you can say that this is, here we are using associative property in addition, because here we are adding two numbers first. So come to question number 3. In question number 3, see in from book, there is a word problem that Sachin scores 52 runs in the first inning and 78 in the second inning. So there are two person, one is Sachin and second is Ajay. There are scores which are given here. So the score of Sachin in first and second inning is given here. See in the board, I have already written. So Sachin, score of Sachin, it is written. First inning it is 52 run, second inning it is 78 run. Similarly, score of Ajay is also written, first inning and second inning. So what is the question? See, here they are asking that who has the higher total score. You have to find the highest total score. So you have to add the two scores of the, you have to add the scores of two innings. So you have to add first 52 and 78. So you will get the total score of Sachin. Then you have to add the total, you have to get the total score of Ajay by adding these two. So as you see, both the numbers are same, just order is different. So already you know, if we add the two numbers and the order are changed, then we will get the same answer again. So if you add the two numbers, you will get the same answer. So next, what you have to do, you will do this by yourself. You have to write like this, total score of Sachin. Then you have to add the two runs, runs of two innings. So you have to add like this, 52 runs plus 78 runs. Again you have to write total score of Ajay. Then you have to write, you have to add the two numbers, that is 78 and 52. See, the order is different. Order is different, but the numbers are same. So when you will add, you will get the same answer. See here, you will get 130. Here also you will get what? 180, 130. So the two numbers are same. Here we can say that commutative property of addition taking place. So who has the highest score? As both the scores are same, so you have to write the both Sachin and Ajay scored the same number, that is 130. So the rest question of exercise 2.2 and exercise 2.3, I will discuss it in the next lecture. So try to practice the remaining, means the previous question, as I have done one or two question from each question. So rest of the question you have to do it by yourself. See, you have to practice it by yourself. So next is chapter checkup, and in chapter checkup already you know that the questions and the things we have discussed inside the chapter, that will be in chapter checkup. So you have to do it by yourself. Try to do chapter checkup question and the remaining question of exercise 2.2 and exercise 2.3 I will be deliver in my next lecture. And one more question is there, that is multiple choice question. You have to do the MCQ question in book itself. Okay, thank you.